So 2 days ago we did catchers, yesterday we did first baseman. So what comes after the catcher and the first baseman class? That's right, second baseman. So today we got the top 7 second basemen, and yes, we have changed it from top 5 to top 7, even though in the title it'll say top 5, just because the two outside of the top 5 are honorable mentions. Now before we dive into this, all I ask is that you hit that like button and that subscribe button, and then we stream each and every single day on Twitch at 1 a.m. Eastern. Make sure you go inside the description box and go ahead and follow all of those links, subscribe to all of those links, and show support through all of those links as well. So starting it off with number 7 is going to be a player that I think is an amazing player to have at his primary position, but if you already have Chipper Jones over there, then this man right here is going to be a great second baseman for you, and it's going to be Jose Ramirez. Now yes, Jose Ramirez does disappoint a little bit when it comes to the contact versus right side of things, but he's a switch hitter, and that's the beauty of him, and that's what makes him so good. And not only that, but he has 125 power against right-handers, so if you just get the PCI anywhere near the ball, usually what happens with hitters that have low contact and higher power than contact is that their power attribute with the normal swing, meaning press an X on the PlayStation or A on the Xbox, the power is usually what dictates how hard the ball is hit, and most of the times the ball is going to be a home run. That's why Joey Gallo, especially on All-Star difficulties, Hall of Fame, and even Legend, whenever he touches the ball and he hits it into fair territories, most of the times it's an extra base hit. It's because the power is the attribute taken over for that contact being made. And then versus lefties, he's great. He has 103 contact versus left, he has 73 power versus left, so obviously he lacks in that department in terms of pop, but the fact that he's a switch hitter and he has a really good swing in the game, that just helps him out tremendously, and you're going to be hitting home runs without a problem with him regardless. 108 vision, it carries over to legend difficulty, no problem, so you're not going to be worried about anything there. The fielding at a 75 is going to stay silver at second base. The reaction at a 78 is going to stay silver at second base too. Now, if you keep him at third base, once you super factor him, he's going to have gold fielding and he'll have beyond gold reaction. Now, the 68 speed is what's tremendous for him, especially to have as a second baseman or a third baseman. You like to have quick, speedy guys on the base paths, especially someone with 70 base running aggressiveness like him, which means he's going to be good in terms of rounding the bases. Now we're going to go to a primary second baseman to get into number 6, and luckily enough for us, we highlighted him just entering that page. It's going to be Jake Cronenworth. The man hit for a cycle not too long ago, so we might be getting a Topps Now card for him, even though we already got a Topps Now card for him, but it's going to be interesting. I want to see what MLB The Show is going to do there. They might just go ahead and upgrade his live series player, but in terms of contact, 100 against both sides, you can't ask for more. 97 power versus right, you can't ask for more. 76 power versus left, once you get him up to parallel 4, he's going to hit that 80 threshold, and you're not going to be worried about anything. Now, the fact that he's not a switch hitter is the only thing that hurts him. 110 vision, it translates over to Hall of Fame, it translates over to Legend. He has relief pitcher as a secondary. I don't know how in the world he has relief pitcher as a secondary, but apparently the man can pitch as well. Now, 85 fielding with 87 reaction. Once you parallel him up to parallel 3, he's going to have diamond reaction. Once he's super factored, he's going to have diamond fielding at second base. 83 speed is really, really good for a second baseman as well. I think if you don't like any of the guys that I'm going to mention above him, he is going to definitely be a great option to use at second base. And if you hear some background noise, that's my mother right there. She over here cutting some food up, and I don't know why she keep making noise. I'm about to kick her out the house. That's cat, that's cat. Anyways, up at number 5 for the top 5, it's gonna be Trey the Man Turner. Now, everybody has loved this card. He was in my top 10, and I just knew he was gonna be a top 10 card because Trey Turner has honestly probably one of the best swings in the game. Not only that, but he plays above his attributes, even though these attributes are insane. So Trey Turner, you slot him in at second base, he's gonna lose that silver fielding until you parallel him up to probably parallel 2, and he's gonna lose that silver reaction until you get him up to parallel 4. Now the 99 speed is gonna make up for the reaction, it's gonna make up for the fielding. The arm strength is not going to be great, but for a second baseman, you don't need great arm strength. When we're talking about the hitting side of things now, he basically gives you more than you could ask for. 110 contact versus right, 125 versus lefties, 99 power versus right, and then 85 power versus versus lefty with 96 vision, you can't really ask for more. If you're asking for more, you're just being greedy. This card is one of the best cards in the game. A lot of people even slot him into center field. That's how much they love him. And honestly, I don't see anything wrong with doing that. Now, going back to second basements, it's going to be my favorite swing inside the game. Let me see how much I'm hitting with it. 538. And then my ball player has a swing too. I'm gonna make my ball player 5'8 just so it can mimic Ozzy Albies perfectly, in my opinion. I think it's gonna work. And that's something that I would suggest a lot of you guys trying out. Going ahead and making your ball player the same height as whatever swing it is that you're using inside the game, because then it's gonna follow the mechanics 100% through. So if you have a great swing or a great batting average with whatever card that is, your ball player is gonna follow and route. Now, Ozzy Albies, he does lack in terms of the contact, just like Jose Ramirez lack in terms of the contact. They both have the same contact, but he is maxed out against lefties, 125, 121, parallel him up to parallel 4, that's 125, 125 on both sides. 87 power versus right, he does slack as opposed to Jose Ramirez in the power versus right department. The 101 vision, just like Jose Ramirez, it translates over to Legend and Hall of Fame. Now, the difference between him and Jose Ramirez is he plays second base as a primary, and he starts off as a gold fielder at second base with gold reaction, and then 74 speed is great speed, a lot faster than Jose Ramirez. It's good enough. He's a switch hitter just like Jose Ramirez, so both of those guys are interchangeable, whoever you want to play second base. And then Ozzy Albies also plays short. Now, I would put Ozzy Albies at second base and leave Jose Ramirez at third. Put Trey Turner at short if you don't have a ball player. And right then and there, you have an amazing lineup. An amazing lineup filled with two switch hitters. But let's continue going back now to the shortstops. This, in terms of Showzone's true overall rating, is number 3. I personally dislike Wander Franco. Let's see how much we're hitting with him. In 5 at-bats, we haven't gotten a base hit. So that just tells you a lot. Wander Franco, I don't know if it's just me. A lot of people say they go ahead and experience the same thing, but he just does not have a good swing in the game. I don't know why. Now, his hitting attributes, if you could hit with him, they're amazing. 117, 105, 94, 84. He meets every single threshold you would want. And then 106 vision, it translates. You go ahead and parallel him up, and he just gets better. 87 fielding, parallel up to 3 is going to be diamond fielding. At second base, it's never going to be diamond, although it'll stay at gold. And then the reaction at second base, same thing, it'll stay at gold. It will never hit diamond. 84 speed is tremendous speed, but I don't know what it is about this card. I couldn't hit with the Future Stars one that got upgraded to a 99, and then I can't hit with this 99 overall card. I don't know what it is. I've been trying to figure out his swing, but for some reason, I just can't. Now, another player that plays second base as a secondary position, and one that we do actually pretty well with, despite a lot of people saying they hate their swing, is Alfonso Soriano. Now, Alfonso Soriano, 94 contact versus right is good enough. 105, 117, 118, all of those are great. He lacks a little bit in terms of the vision department at an 82, but you can bypass that because he has amazing contact. At second base, he's still gonna have diamond fielding, he's still gonna have diamond reaction, and then the 97 speed, 96 steal, 99 aggressiveness, this is probably the best base runner you have for second base. And yes, Trey Turner is going to go ahead and rival him, especially when you super fractor Trey Turner, because this man right here is paralleled up to parallel 4. But if you super fractor Alfonso, he's going to go ahead and rival Trey Turner without a problem for the best base runner. He comes in at 104.88. And then coming in at number 1 in terms of second baseman's true overall ratings, this should not be a surprise to anyone. I think Jackie Robinson, if you can hit with Jackie Robinson, which we're hitting 339 with, and 168 at bats, so clearly we can't hit like that. Because if you look at Marcus Semien, we're hitting 417 with him in 168, so they got the same amount of at bats, and I hit way less with Jackie Robinson. Now, if you can hit with Jackie Robinson, you like his swing, this is the complete second baseman for you. He's gonna have the fielding, it's not gonna start off diamond, it's gonna start off gold. The only reason it's diamond for me is because I paralleled him up to parallel 4. The reaction is gonna start off diamond, although, so that's perfect. The speed, I'm not sure if it starts off at a 99, but if it does, then you don't got anything to worry about in terms of fielding, because his speed is gonna make up for it. And same thing goes for the contact, same thing goes for the power, same thing goes for the vision. Everything translates. He starts off with 80 power minimum, so he's gonna meet the threshold of 80 power, and he's just gonna be a great card to use overall. There's a reason why he was a 99 overall that started off in the game along with Chipper Jones, Big Poppy, and Alfonso Soriano. These are four of the best cards, and Jackie Robinson most likely is going to be an end game card until the game comes out for MLB The Show 22. It's just whether or not you can actually hit with him. If you can actually hit with him, then obviously you got a lot of options to use at second base, a lot of switch hitting options, and a lot of players that can give you better production than Jackie Robinson, even though you are going to be taking a hit in the fielding department and speed department. But if you did end up enjoying today's content, please make sure to hit that like button or subscribe button. Go ahead and click on the description box. Follow me on Twitch. We stream each and every single day at 1 a.m. Eastern. And then go ahead and check out all the other links there. Join, subscribe, follow, do all that jazz. Have a blessed day and night. Stay positive, stay safe, stay blessed. And I will catch you all on the next one. Peace out.